I have memories of you in high school playing on stage, Kaki, with drums. Mm-hmm. So you were drumming.
I play drums, yeah.
Are you still?
Yeah, I played a lot of drums on records that I've made. And drums were the, like, I guess in a weird way, drums were the public and the social aspect of music for me. So everyone needed a drummer, and everyone needed a bass player. So I was there to fill that role in everyone's band or doing, you know, that was kind of what I did to hang out. And guitar became more and more of this closed thing because, you know, I really was into solo guitar at an early age. And, you know, that just became something you don't really hang out and do with people. It became my way in to having friends. And guitar became kind of like my way into me.
When did you first start moving from conventional playing to tapping the fretboard?
Well, I had started playing fingerstyle, which, you know, has to do with these the fake nails and detuning the guitar into other tunings. You know, I'd already been experimenting probably around like age 14. And it wasn't too long, you know, a few years of that where I'd learn a new concept for the guitar, something that I didn't think you could do. And then it would like open this world to me and I would just get so into it for a few months and I'd learn the next step. And, you know, so I kind of almost went down this rabbit hole in a way. And before I knew it, I didn't even know that what I was doing was actually kind of strange or something that wouldn't normally be done. And tapping kind of came naturally part of that. You know, it was like, well, how do I get the sound that I want? And, well, that guy does it like this, so why don't I just try to do that on the guitar? Like, I need to hear this note, and the only way I can do it while hearing the other notes I want to hear is by maybe, like, pressing it with my right hand instead of playing it with my left. Or, you know, the only way I can feel this pulse of the beat is if I, you know, bang a little on the guitar. But there's a lot of problem solving that comes with when you're writing
math?
Guitar. I was actually pretty good at math in Westminster. Yeah.
I can tell. So will you show me?
I will show you, yeah. So here's sort of an example. You know, it's kind of a two-hand technique.
What? Kaki.
Thanks. That's...
Wow.
Well, you know, for instance, this note has to be tuned to a certain thing.
Okay.
In order for all the rest of it to fit together, and I have to sort of land here, but then get out of the way with this hand, so it'd be hard to cross that, so I might... You know, there is a lot of math that kind of goes into it without adding up numbers.
You can tell. See you sitting this closely doing this thing to the guitar, and then like a few years ago when Rolling Stone called you the first female guitar god and you said, meh, that's just hyperbole.
Here's the thing, I play guitar for a living and this guitar is way smarter than me, and I know that. Like, I say this a lot, but, and I really mean it from the bottom of my heart, I am a guitar student and I will be for the rest of my life. There's too much to learn in a lifetime. And there's something beautiful and challenging and humbling about that I don't want to let go of. I am always seeking out new sounds. I am always seeking out new technique and ideas, but they're always a means to an end. Let's face it, I could be hung upside down and play guitar. You know, there's all kinds of tricks that are out there, but they're not artistic, and they're not beautiful, they're not moving.